This time, the Pac-Man is chasing us, and his mouth is open at the 30 degree angle, and the length of its upper and bottom jaws is exactly square root of 6 pixels. Now, if we lose the eye of the Pac-Man, the question is, can we somehow calculate this yellow shaded area of a Pac-Man? Well, if you want to try this interesting problem for yourself, you can pause the video right now and then come back and check your solution. Alright, so let's solve this Pac-Man problem. So first, we're going to start by completing the circle, and then we're going to pull the line of symmetry since we know that the length of its upper and bottom jaw is identical. Now let's mark the characteristic vertices as A, B, and C, and we will also mark the center of our circle as O. Let's pull a line from O to B and from O to C. Now we will use the inscribed angle theorem to find the angle at the point O. And just to remind you, this theorem states that an angle theta, which is inscribed in a circle, is exactly the half of a central angle that subtends the same arc of a circle. Now we can use this in our favor. If we mark all the points the same way as we did on our sketch on the left, you can clearly see that the angle theta corresponds to our angle of 30 degrees, which means that the angle at the point O will represent the central angle, which is twice the size of our 30 degree angle, and this is, of course, a 60 degree angle. Alright, so now let's take a look at the radius of our circle. You can clearly see that both lines OC and OB represent the radius of our circle, and we can label their length as R. Now we can pull another line from the point B to the point C. This line will form an isosceles triangle with the angle of 60 degrees. This means that the remaining two angles must also be 60 degree angles. So this triangle is actually an equilateral triangle. This implies that the line BC is also equal to the radius of our circle. So, if we put the point D at the intersection of this line BC and the line of symmetry, this point will divide the line BC into two identical parts. So, the line BD will have the length of R over 2. Now, the line OD will represent the height of this triangle. And since we know that the height of the equilateral triangle is equal to its side times square root of 3 over 2, we can just substitute the value of the side for R and get this length. Now, if we again rotate the radius, you can clearly see that the line OA will also represent the radius of our circle. Now let's clear the image a little bit. And we can notice that we have this really neat right triangle ADB. And we can use the Pythagorean theorem on this one. We can say that the sum of the squares of its legs AD and DB is equal to the square of his hypotenuse AB. Now we can substitute our values since the line AD is equal to the sum of the radius of our circle and the height of our equilateral triangle, and the line DB will represent the half of our radius. So we can now simplify this equation by putting R over 2 as a common factor for the first term, and we will square up the rest. Now for the second factor of our first term, we will use the formula for square of binomial to develop this equation further. Now we can simplify this even more to get the following. Here we can isolate R square over 4 as a common factor, and after simplification we will get the following. Now we can isolate 4 as a common factor from our brackets and get the following. Here we can of course cancel out 4s and get that R square times the quantity of 2 plus square root of 3 is equal to 6. From here we will get that r square is equal to 6 over quantity of 2 plus square root of 3. Now we can rationalize this and get the following. After final simplification, we will get that r square is equal to 6 times the quantity of 2 minus square root of 3. For now, we will leave this value as it is. Alright, so now let's continue by finding the typical areas of the difference between the full circle and the Pac-Man area. So we can start with this red triangle AOB. We can say that the area of this triangle is equal to the product of its base and the height. In our case, the base is equal to AO and the height is equal to BD. We can substitute the values and, after simplification, we will get that the area of this red triangle is equal to r square over 4. Alright, now let's try to find the area of this blue circular sector. This sector has a 60 degree central angle. So, since our full circle has a 360 degree central angle, this means that this sector is 1/6 of a full circle. Now, due to the symmetry, we can conclude that the triangle AOC is equal to the red triangle AOB. Now, let's try to find the area of a Pac-Man. This area will be equal to the area of a full circle of r squared pi minus the combined area of a two red triangles plus the area of our circular sector. Now we can substitute our values, and if we simplify by finding the common denominator, we will get the following. From here, we will get that our area is equal to 5 r squared pi minus 3 r squared over 6. We can isolate r squared over 6 as a common factor and get the following. Now it's a great time to substitute the value of the r square, which we got earlier. And we will get the following value. Here we can cancel 6 and finally get that the area of our Pac-Man is equal to quantity of 2 minus square root of 3 times the quantity of 5 pi minus 3. Of course, we can calculate this and get that this Pac-Man's area is actually equal to 3.4 squared pixels, and this is our solution. Now I have a little task for you guys. If you're up to it, try to find the formula for the area of the Pac-Man that will work for any angle and any length of the Pac-Man's jaws. Basically, what I would like you to do is to find the area which is function of the angle theta of the Pac-Man's mouth and the value of the length of its jaws. Just as a quick tip, you will need to use the trigonometry in order to find this function. Alright, so I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more content like this. And of course, until next time, see you guys and take care.